It's Evan Gill. I'm from group 13, and today I'm going to present a simple looping process that we're gonna supposed to do. So let's move on. So this is my flowchart. Okay, so I'm just gonna start off with a simple start, and then our flowchart is all about accumulating a value from an equation. Where I just want to show you the equation. So this is the equation. This is the equation. So first we have to initialize the value. For example, R16 is the value of x, R20 is the value of the x that we're gonna times with. And you see it can be find equation. R19 is the constant, and R21 is the value that we're gonna accumulate the values together into a single register. And then next we're gonna move on to the process of multiplication and adding process in order to get the equation. These two represents the for the equation to obtain the equation, and R21 represents the sum of the values that we're gonna get. Next we're gonna move on to, since our loop is based for 2, 3, and 4, so if the loop reaches 5, the loop will end. And we're gonna get the accumulated value for 2, 3, and 4. If it's not, then it will go on until it reaches the value of 5, and then the loop will end. So if, after that, if the loop already end, we will sum up the value of R21, and the loop will end. So it's gonna move on to create a code. So this is my code. As we can see, accumulated value of y equals 5 equals 3. For 2, 3, and 4. Okay, and accumulated value store accumulated value into a register. So we're gonna start the loop with our value of 2. Okay, let me just step into. Okay, we're just gonna start with value of 2. Okay, since this is an incremented loop, as you can see, increment. So we're just gonna start from 2 to 3 to 4, and you will end at 5 because we only want value of 2, 3, and 4. So 5 is just like the end of the loop, if you reach 5. So okay, we had a store value of R23 and R19, 5. And then we're gonna store value of, let's say to get the equation, we had to add R19, R20. As we can know, R19 is 5x and R20 is 3 for the constant. And this is the value for R19. So, yeah, more sorry. And then we're gonna accumulate the value into a register. So you can see that R21 holds the same value for R19 for now, because it's at the first iteration. So this would be for number 2. So the first iteration of the loop. So then we would move on. Then this is the check. We will check whether the x has reached the end of the loop. And end of the loop, which is 4. Because why did I put 5 here? Because we want the value of 2, 3, and 4. If I put it 4 here, it wouldn't accumulate the value of 4. So 5, once it reaches 5, it will end. The end, and you will jump to the next loop. So I'm just gonna move on. And we can see that R16 is now 3. And we're just going to step 2. And now we can see the value of accumulator from R from 2 and 3, which is now 1F. So it's going to step 2. So this is the accumulated value for 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so we have reached the end of the loop. So once I press this, since value is 5 now, isn't it? So once you reach 5, it will go to the next loop, which is this lights loop that I created. It's just an infinite loop, and that just shows the end of the loop. So that's all for me. Thank you very much.